In this video, let us discuss about number system conversion in digital fundamentals. Here, I would like to discuss about the conversion between all the four types of number system: decimal to binary, decimal to octal, and decimal to hexadecimal, and vice versa. Now, let us see the relation between decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal numbers. In decimal, the number system goes on from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and it continues. The binary equivalent of 0 in 4-bit representation is 0, 0, 0, 0. Starting from the LSB bit, the 0 has the positional weight 2 power 0, which is equal to 1. And the next bit from LSB has the positional weight 2 power 1, that is 2. The third bit from LSB has a positional weight 2 power 2, that is 4. Finally, the fourth bit from LSB has a positional weight of 2 power 3, that is 8. Now, the positional weight are multiplied with each position values, which gives the binary equivalent. Now, let us consider one example, decimal number 11. To represent 11 in binary, first we have to write the positional weights. Starting from the LSB, the positional weights are 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. Now, we have to put 1 or 0 so that the total sum should be equal to 11. Here, under 8, we can put 1. Now, 11 minus 8 is 3. So, we can put 1 under 2 power 0 and 2 power 1. Now, the binary equivalent becomes 1011 to the base 2. Next, the octal number system has the digits from 0 to 7. After 7, we should start from 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Then again 20, 21. Likewise, it goes on. The hexadecimal number system has the digits 0 to 7 and from A to F. And A is equivalent to 10 in decimal. And B is equivalent to 11 in decimal. C is equivalent to 12 in decimal, D is equivalent to 13 in decimal, E is equivalent to 14 in decimal, F is equivalent to 15 in decimal number system. Let us see how to convert decimal to binary number system. In a decimal number system, there will be two parts. Before the decimal point, we call the number as integer part. After the decimal point, we call the number as fractional part. Step 1. First, we have to convert the integer part, that is the number before the decimal point. For this, we have to use successive division by 2 method and read the result from bottom to top. Second, if there exists fractional part, then we have to convert the fractional part to binary equivalent. For this, we have to use successive multiplication by 2 method and then read the result from top to bottom. Now, consider an example. We have to convert a decimal number to binary. Now, let us consider the integer part. That is 12. For this, we have to use successive division by 2 method. So, first divide this 12 by 2, which gives 6 as quotient and 0 as remainder. Next, divide 6 by 2. We get 3 as quotient and 0 as remainder. Next, divide 3 by 2. Here we get the quotient 1 and the remainder is 1. Now, we have to read the answer from bottom to top, that is 1100. After completing the integer part, consider the fractional part, 0.875. Here we have to use successive multiplication by 2 method. Since it is binary conversion, we are multiplying the base with 2. First, take 0.875 multiply by 2. We get 1.75. Keep the integer part as it is and take only the fractional part, that is 0.75, and multiply with 2. We get 1.5. Now keep the integer part as it is and take the fractional part, 0.5, and multiply by 2, which gives 1.0. Now there is no fractional part, that is the fractional part here is 0. So now we can stop with this and read the integer value from top to bottom, that is 111. So now the answer is 1100.111 to the base 2. Let us see how to convert decimal to octal. In a decimal number system, there will be two parts. Before the decimal point, we call the number as integer part. After the decimal number point, we call the number as fractional part. First, we have to convert the integer part, that is the number before the decimal point. For this, we have to use successive division by 8 method and read the result from bottom to top. Second, if there exists fractional part, then we have to convert the fractional part to octal equivalent. So by using successive multiplication by 8 method, read the result from top to bottom. Now consider an example. We have to convert this decimal to octal. First, let us consider the integer part, 378. Use successive division by 8 method. Divide 378 by 8. Here we get the quotient 47 with remainder 2. Then divide 47 by 8. We get the quotient 5 with remainder 7. Now read the answer from bottom to top. That is 572. Now consider the fractional part, that is 0.93. Here we use the successive multiplication by 8 method. Since it is octal conversion, we are multiplying with the octal base 8. Now take 0.93, multiply with 8, we get 7.44. Keep the integer part as it is and take only the fractional part, 0.44, and multiply by 8, we get 3.52. Keep the integer part as it is and take the fractional part, 0.52, and multiply with 8, we get 4.16. Likewise, it goes on till we reach the fractional part to be 0. If it continues, stop with 4 digits. After the decimal point, we need only 4 digits. And read the integer value from top to bottom, that is 7341. Now the answer is 572.7341 to the base 8. Now let us see how to convert decimal to hexadecimal. So first we have to convert the integer part, that is the number before the decimal point. For this, use successive division by 16 method and read the result from bottom to top. Second, if there exists a fractional part, we have to convert that fractional part to hexadecimal equivalent. For this, use successive multiplication by 16 method and read the result from top to bottom. Consider an example. We have to convert this decimal number to hexadecimal number. First, consider the integer part, 3509, divide by 16, which gives the quotient 219 with remainder 5. Then divide 219 by 16. We get the quotient 13 with the remainder 11. In hexadecimal, the number 13 has the decimal equivalent of D. In hexadecimal, the number 11 has the decimal equivalent B. Now read answers from bottom to top. That is D, B, 5. After completing the integer part, consider the fractional part. That is 0.75. Here, use successive multiplication by 16 method. Since it is hexadecimal conversion, we are multiplying with the base 16. First take 0.75 multiplied by 16. Keep the integer part as it is and take only the fractional part. But here the fractional part is 0. So now read the integer part 12 and the equivalent decimal is C. Hence the hexadecimal for decimal equivalent is D, B, 5, point C to the base 16. Now let us see how to convert binary to decimal. This conversion is done by positional weight method. Here each binary digit of a number is multiplied by its positional weight and the product terms are added to obtain the decimal number. Now let us consider one example. Convert this binary number to decimal. For that, first we need the positional weights. That is, starting from this LSB, the positional weight is 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4. Then after the decimal point, we'll be having 2 power minus 1, 2 power minus 2, 2 power minus 3. So now we have to multiply these positional weights with the corresponding positions. So 1 into 2 power 4, then 1 into 2 power 3, then 0 into 2 power 2, 1 into 2 power 1, 1 into 2 power 0. Then plus that 1 into 2 power minus 1, 0 into 2 power minus 2, 1 into 2 power minus 3. Now we have to add all the values. We'll be getting the decimal equivalent number. Now let us see how to convert binary to octal. Starting from the binary point, make groups of 3 bits each and on either side of the binary point. Replace each 3-bit binary group by the equivalent octal digit. Now consider an example. We have to convert this binary number to octal. For this, first we have to group the binary into 3 bits since it is octal. So starting from this point, binary point, we have to group. So 001, then 111, then 101, then 10. Then after the point 0111. Okay, so here while we are seeing there is only 2 bits. Now we need 3 bits. So in order to get 3 bits, we have to add a 0 at the last. And after the point also there is only 1 bit. We need 3 bits. So we have to add 2 more zeros here. So after converting into the binary equivalent, we have to convert this binary equivalent to octal value. So here by using the positional weight, we can able to convert this binary to octal. So this position is 2 power 0, that is 1. 2 power 1 is 2. We'll be putting here. Then here 2 power 0, that is 1. We all know that 2 power 0 is 1. That is anything power 0 is 1. So here 1, then 2 power 1 is 2 into 0. Here 2 power 2. That is 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Likewise, we have to convert all the numbers. We'll be getting 2571.34 to the base 8. Next, let us see binary to hexadecimal conversion. Starting from the binary point, make groups of 4 bits each and on either side of the binary point. Replace each 4-bit group by the equivalent hexadecimal digits. Now, let us consider one example. We have to convert this binary to hexadecimal. So, for this, we have to group the binary into 4 bits. For starting from this binary point, we have to group at the left and right. So, 1101, 0111, 101. Next, here there is only 4 bit, write it as it is. Next, see here last, there is only 3 bit. So, in order to make into 4 bit, we have to add a 0 at the last. So, now we have got the 4 bits. Now, we have to convert this 4 bit to hexadecimal number. That is 101 is 5, 111 is 7, then 13 is the equivalent is D point then 7. Now the result is 570.7 to the base 16. Now let us see how to convert the octal to decimal number. Here the conversion is done by positional weights. Each octal digit of the number is multiplied by its positional weight and the product terms are added to obtain the decimal number. Now let us consider one example. We have to convert this octal number to decimal. First we have to write the positional weights. Starting from the decimal point, the LSB bit 8 power 0, next 8 power 1, 8 power 2, 8 power 3. So in the fractional part, 8 power minus 1, 8 power minus 2. Now we have to multiply this positional weight with the position values. After multiplying, we have to sum all the values. We'll be getting the decimal number. Now let us see how to convert octal to binary. Each octal digit is replaced by its 3-bit binary equivalent. So here we have to convert octal number to binary. First, write the number as it is, and then we all know 2 power 3 is 8. So, only we are considering 3 bit for binary representation here. So, write each digit with 3 bit binary representation. The positional weight we all know 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2. So, 2 power 1 is 2 plus 2 power 0, that is 1. So, 2 plus 1 is 3. Likewise, we have to convert all the octal digits to binary numbers. That is what our answer. Next, we have to convert octal to hexadecimal. For this, first we have to write the octal number. Then we have to convert this octal number to binary, which will be 3 bit. And then we have to convert 3 bit binary number to 4 bit binary number. And then we have to convert it into hexadecimal equivalent. Now let us consider one example. This is an octal number. Since its base is 8, we can call this as octal number. We have to convert this octal number to hexadecimal. So first write the octal number as it is. And then we have to convert each octal number to binary 3 bits. 7 can be represented as 111. 5 can be represented as 101. 6 can be represented as 110, then the decimal point. 6 can be represented as 110, then 0000. 3 is 011. After writing like this, we have to split the digits into 4 bits, starting from this point, octal point. So 0111, add this one also here. So 1110. Next, 10 comes here. Include this 11, which becomes 4 bit. Next, there will be only 1 here. So, in order to make into 4 bit, we have to add 3 more zeros. So, see, after the decimal point, 110, take 0 from here, then 2 bits 00, take 2 bits from here, 01, then there will be only 1 here. So, we have to add 3 more zeros here in order to make 4 bit. Next, after converting into 4 bits, we have to write the hexadecimal equivalent. So this is 1, then this one 14, which is E. Also 14, which is E. Then 12, its equivalent is C. And here 1, then 8. So now the answer is 1EE.C18 to the base 16. Next, let us see how to convert hexadecimal to decimal. Here the conversion is done by positional weight method. Each hexadecimal digit of the number is multiplied by its positional weight and the product terms are added to obtain the decimal number. Now let us convert this hexadecimal number to decimal. So for that, first we need the positional weight. So since it's a hexadecimal number, we have to use this base as the positional weight. 16 power 0, 16 power 1, 16 power 2. And after the fractional part, 16 power minus 1, 16 power minus 2, 16 power minus 3. Next, we have to multiply these positional weights with the positional values. So 7 into 16 power 0, C into 16 power 1, 5 into 16 power 2. Then in the fractional part, 0 into 16 power minus 1. Then here E, E is equivalent as 14, 14 into 16 power minus 2. B is equivalent as 11, 11 into 16 power minus 3. Then we have to add all the values and then we'll be getting the decimal number. Next, let us convert. Let us see how to convert hexadecimal to binary. Here each hexadecimal digit is replaced by its 4-bit binary representation. Consider this example. Here the hexadecimal number is to be converted to binary. Now write the question as it is and then convert this each digit by 4-bit binary by using the positional weights. Here 2 power 0 is 1, 2 power 1 is 2. So 2 plus 1, 3. Likewise, you have to write all the numbers. And this is what our answer. Then hexadecimal to octal conversion. Here, first convert the hexadecimal number to binary. And then convert this binary to octal. Now, let us see one example. Here, we have to convert this hexadecimal number to octal. First, write the hexadecimal number as it is. Then we have to convert this to binary. That is, here 2 power 4 is 16. So we have to split into 4, 4 digits. So B is 11. So 1011. 9 is 1001. Likewise, you have to write in 4-bit binary. And then starting from this binary point, take 3 digits. 111. Then take this one here and 0, 0, 1, 1. Next, take the 0 here, 1, another one from here, then 3-bit. Likewise, you have to arrange to 3-bits. So if there is only one digit or 2-digit, we have to add one more zeros. Next, you have to convert this binary number to equivalent octal digit. So this is 5, 6, 3, 7.534. This is what our answer. So it's a tutorial session. In order to practice the concept explained in this video, I suggest you to work out the tutorials enclosed in this video. Check the answers for the tutorial questions.